football fans facing tough new procedures tonight, all in the name of safety.
And reporter Andrew Del Greco was there as the metal detectors were put to the test. Drew?
Yeah, Mike, this is a growing trend at professional sporting events and now at local sporting events. Now, school officials say that the shootings and all the violence around this entire country, of course, have been well documented. And now it's time, they say, for local leaders to be more proactive.
If you're not doing it right now, you ought to think about doing it.
Call it a sign of the times. People young and old stopped by security staff on the way to simply watch a football game. Wanded and monitored for guns and weapons, every single person bag checked as well.
This has nothing to do with anything going on local. It's just the reality of the world that we live in.
Steel Valley School District Superintendent Ed Weir says the new security measures at high school football games this season have nothing to do with any recent specific violent crimes in our area, but rather, he says, the hard-to-deny national trend of violence, which he says puts every citizen everywhere at risk.
There's no place that people gather in public anymore that is absolutely safe from violence. The shootings in Colorado at the movie theater are a perfect example of that.
The first night of metal detection here at Munhall's William V. Campbell Athletic Field seemed to operate smoothly, and few people we spoke with minded what they called only a minor inconvenience, which they said does not outweigh the benefits.
I think it actually is with everything that's going on. It actually made me feel really safe at school, so for like everyone to feel safe here, it's kind of worth it.
And also, Steel Valley pulled out a blowout win tonight, but the bottom line, there were really no problems that we saw. It seemed to be very smooth as the new security measures were rolled out, say, and they will be out from here on out for the coming years, at least here. Reporting live, I'm Andrew Del Greco, Channel 4 Action News.